Hello, you're welcome to Entrepreneurs Corner. This is a program that talks about entrepreneurs and their business. So today I have a guest, an amazing guest with me with so much creativity. You want to know him? Don't worry, you'll know him. So I'd like us to go on a quick break. When we come back, you know our guest. I am Kehinde Bashir. You're welcome to Eco Art Blog. Glad to have you back. If you're just joining us, this is Entrepreneur Corner, a program where we bring in entrepreneurs from different walks of life to talk about their business. So today I have a man of great talent, and he has been he has been doing well in the art industry, in person of Adeoju Oluwaseun Adesoji. You're welcome.
Okay, thank you once again for having me. Adeoju Oluwaseun Adesoji is a visual artist with the brand Desoji Art. So I'm a graduate of law, and with my works, I depict issues that everyone, regardless of their age, regardless of their color, they can relate with.
So Adesoji, what inspired you into art?
Well, okay, thank you for the question. What inspired me into art? I would say a desire to lend my voice to the world. I am moved by a desire to bring about fulfillment through creativity, and art has been a reason or a means through which I could do that. You know, I could reach out to the world through my art, and also art has given me that platform to pass messages across, even to generations yet unborn, because I believe that art, you know, is going to outlive even the artist.
So I feel that if you have something doing, there are some things that might, you know, want to distract it. So now let's go to that. That brings us to the challenges. So what are those peculiar challenges that you have faced or continue to face in the course of staying in this business?
Okay, so over time, at some point at the early stage, one of the challenges was getting up supplies, materials. Like, our materials are not Nigerian made, most of them are not Nigerian made. So the challenge of having to import materials, and but now today, by God's grace, thanks to the innovations here and there, you know, we have Amazon, we have different platforms where you could order, and then now we also have art stores that we can actually get these imported materials from. So that to a large extent has been sorted out. And another challenge we faced at some point was having to meet up with, you want to do conceptual works which are personal in terms of getting messages across, and then you also have the side of you having to work for clients.
Draw
my daddy, draw my mommy, draw my girlfriend, and all those sweet stuffs. You know, and interestingly, some of them have deadlines which they want you to work with, and you know, like, and they still want the very best. So it now boils down to you to have to manage your time and still give them the best, still serve them hot. So now over time I've been able to deal with it by the grace of God. You know, the challenge of having to manage my time effectively. Another challenge I get to say, you know, at some point everybody wants, you know, the early stages of it too, you know, your parents want our parents, their generation, you know, you're either a lawyer, a doctor, and all this. And interestingly, me being a graduate of law, at some point I had to go through that challenge of, okay, are you sure this is what you want to do? Or you want to diversify and follow the line of your passion and all those things. So thank God I'm here now. Definitely going to complete the process of law, but then now I think because that issue of acceptance is no longer is no longer a challenge, because my parents and my siblings, they support me like 24/7, like 100%, even 200%. So we're good.
Oh, that's good. Mommy and daddy, thank you. I can see from your work, creative, creative mindset. Okay, now we know that creativity is at the heart of your job. So how do you ensure constant or continuous creativity in your crafts to stay, you know, ahead of competitors?
For me, I'm driven, like I said, with the desire to bring about fulfillment through creativity. So without creativity, this OG is nothing. So knowing fully well that, okay, creativity is at the heart of my job, I need to, one of the things I do is, one of the things that actually for creativity is information. You need to be aware of your environment. You need to be aware of the things that are happening all around and all. So I try as much as I can to stay informed And aside that, I ensure that I don't just get carried away by the praises, by the attention of the media, by the other responsibilities. So at some point in time in the year, I do take out time to withdraw and have some breathing space away from the regular routine of studio works and other responsibilities and all. So I try to have retreats. And also, I create a, there's this atmosphere I like creating around me. I'm a lover of music, good music. So I try as much as possible to also embrace that environment whereby it also helps. And then prayer also helps my life. Like, I'm nothing without prayer. The God factor of my creativity can also not be silenced that way, because God actually inspires me. So many times, I'm a Christian, and so many times he wants me to pass some messages across. So it's more about information about what is happening around, what is happening in the moment, what do you want to address and all. So information fuels my creativity, then the God factor fuels it. And I also create out time not to be overwhelmed by responsibilities and activities all around. So I take time to withdraw and, you know, reflect on these things.
Wow, that's a very good one. Self-disciplined. That's a very good one. So now I was going through your pictures or your work on Instagram. So I noticed that you've done so well for our celebrities, in the industry. And the likes of Daddy Adeboye, Dunsi Oyekan, Mercy Chinwo. So how did you get these people on your feet? Like, how did you do it?
Well, there's a popular saying that you're just about maybe maximum 7 or minimum of a 4 people away from anybody you want to meet in the world. So let me use, for example, I want to meet the president. Let's say I just need to know somebody that will lead me to probably the local government chairman. Local government chairman will lead me to the governor and all those things. So, well, for me, I would say it's been favor. And this favor was bred by humility. Humility, you know, I believe gives birth to favor. So I was privileged at some point, at every point in time, to, you know, get to meet someone that could lead me to them. So, and those are platforms that I sincerely do not take for granted. It's been privilege. It's not of works. It's not because I'm the best or anything. That's just been favor, basically.
Okay, now there's this perception we get nowadays about artworks, and I feel that, I don't know, but because, you know, you're an artist and I want to hear from you. Do you think people, normally, you know, on a norm, you should, when you work in an environment, be it an office or a place, you should have an artwork displayed. So do you think people do appreciate artwork now, or they don't, or they don't just want to have interest in it anymore?
Well, I think this has been a norm, right, from the inception. Although, there was a generation, a period whereby art was really appreciated. So an extent, you know, the early stages of art and all, like, you know, Benin art and Benin and all those stuff. Like, in fact, even the white art to come around and, you know, do some stuff, which, you know. But then now, as it is, because of the times and seasons are changing. There was a point in time where people don't really, you know, when they even see artists as like all these roadside artists kind of thing and all the likes. But then the times and seasons are changing, because a whole lot of things that the generation we are in now, it has actually changed a lot of things, and thanks to the media as well. So basically, everybody will not always like a particular thing. I don't think that's that thing that everybody, even our God, some people are angry at God and they don't even like, you know, stuff like that. But then at this stage that we're in, gradually I feel art is being appreciated gradually. Because now you see that in movies, they want to have a display of art in part some scenery, in some scenes. You get to some banks and all these other things. That doesn't change the fact that some people do not even value it. And one another thing is, appreciation is not just in, I love this art. Appreciation is also in, I'm willing to break the bank to get this art. There's also the part of, I love this art and I don't think it's this what so, this worthy of this amount and all. So there's appreciation in terms of the love personal, and there's appreciation in terms of the funding, in terms of the pricing of the art. So gradually, and I think basically, I think it's just about it's a world thing now, it's a global thing. So even if nobody's appreciating your present environment, of course you have the world as an audience. So we have collectors all over the world who are, you know, you just need to keep doing what you're doing, and with time, well,
everything will be fine.
Yes.
Okay, so now, do you think your business would be more successful in another environment?
Well, another environment, I'm like, I've never at any point in time regretted being in Nigeria.
He knows
why he positioned me where I am, so I'm not complaining either. So and thank God for the season that we're in. It's the media world. It's whether you could be in the developed countries in quotes,
yeah,
and still not. It's not every artist that is over there that they know. But thanks to the media now, you can be in one corner of your room, and the world is seeing you, and this world is craving for what you carry. So it all boils down to an individual thing. Like, just keep doing what you're doing, and in the environments that you're in, definitely, just like with time. So in this environment that I'm in, I feel at some point in time, you realize that the people around, do they really appreciate what you're doing, or they just see as just one jobless person and all those things? Well, I'm not moved by all those things because, well, the media is there for me, and there's a God factor that is there. So,
yeah, that's true. So, if you were to diversify into another business, what business would it be and why?
Okay, well, business, yeah, okay. Doing any business without passion is definitely going to lead to some sort of depression because even when going gets tougher, you need passion to keep going. So other areas of passion for me is, I would say, acting and then into sports. At some point, I had to just let go of sports so that I could further education and all, football precisely and all. So, well, if I'm to diversify, even if probably I would not be practicing in terms of being a player or something, definitely probably going to coaching or scouting and all those sweet stuff like that. So it's either acting for me, and or sports, basically.
Okay, now that I'm called, you're a creative person. it's too much. Okay, so if you had one piece of advice to some just starting out, what would it be?
Thank you for the privilege.
You're welcome.
Yeah, so basically, I would say, do not underestimate the power of God, the God factor in whatever you're doing. Okay. Start it with Him. Like, in fact, He knows everything. He knows the idea that would sell better in these times and seasons that we're in. So, the God factor is very, very important. And beyond, just aside the God factor, we also need to keep creating. I know there will be discouragements, or there are even discouragements as we speak, but then just keep creating, keep doing your thing. Like, nobody said it was going to be easy. If you're going to be asking the successful people today, they add their stories to tell. They have their stories to tell. And also, just keep doing what you're doing. Keep creating the content. Keep developing, keep improving, keep researching, and don't stop. And then also seek for means to, the world, it's a busy world already. It's a busy field, whatsoever, there are 1,001 people doing whatsoever field you're in.
Yes.
So you just need to keep thinking on how to, come out differently. What is that unique thing that you can do to make this better? Do you understand? So like I said, art is wide for us, but our messages separate us, makes us different. Our styles makes us different, what we're passing across. So keep creating, be creative, and also with time, stay consistent. Like, consistency is very, very, it's very, very important. Keep doing what you're doing. It's not today you are black, tomorrow you are yellow, and then we don't know. Or today you are on duty, tomorrow you are off duty. And you don't even know when that jackpot would come. So just keep doing what you're doing, with time. Time is what would actually tell eventually. So keep creating, and don't put God aside. Involve Him in the equation then. With time, is going to make it work out.
Wow. Bravo, bravo, bravo. Thank you. So you've heard it from the acid's mouth. Keep pushing. Consistency is one thing you should do, and don't you put, the God factor away from what you're doing. Yeah, and I have been speaking with Adeojoluwaseun Adesoji, and it has been an amazing time with this great man. And that's it on Entrepreneur's Corner. Until we come your way next time, don't forget to follow us on all our social media platforms at Eko Art Blog. I am Kehinde Bashir. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.